Hello and welcome to another TA Tech Tip. In this tech tip, we will show you how to load polymer pellets on the Discovery Hybrid Rheometer for running melt rheology experiments. The TA Instruments Discovery Hybrid Rheometers are commonly used to study the melt rheology of polymers. In this tech tip, we will be using a 25mm parallel plate setup with an ETC oven. Other plate sizes and temperature control systems can also be used for this application. If the polymer sample is already pre-molded in a disc form, then it is easy to load it directly onto the plate. In many cases though, polymer samples can be irregularly shaped, such as powders or pellets. We will therefore use a melt ring that will allow us to quickly and easily load these pellets onto the plate. To get started, attach the upper and lower 25mm parallel plate geometry to the Discovery Hybrid Rheometer and calibrate the geometry. Close the ETC oven. The new Discovery Hybrid Rheometer is equipped with a brand new One Touch Away app-style touchscreen that greatly enhances the usability by placing key instrument features at your fingertips. Using this touchscreen, preheat the geometry to the measurement temperature. Make sure you select purge gas only if there is no liquid nitrogen or ACS-based low temperature cooling accessories attached to your rheometer. Then zero the geometry gap at the test temperature. Insert the polymer melt ring around the lower plate and close the oven immediately. After about 2 minutes of equilibration, open the oven, load the pellets or the powder sample onto the lower plate, lower the upper geometry until it is near the edge of the melt ring, taking care not to crush the ring, and close the oven immediately. Let the polymer melt and the geometry equilibrate. Open the oven. Wearing appropriate PPE, remove the polymer melt ring using a pair of tweezers. Slightly lower the upper geometry until it squeezes the pellets further down and close the oven immediately. Use the instrument touchscreen to send the geometry to the trim gap, which is typically 5% above the measurement or the geometry gap. For example, if your measurement gap is 1mm, then you set the trim gap to be at 1.05 mm. Allow the sample to equilibrate and relax at the test temperature. You can use the axial force readings on the touchscreen to monitor the sample relaxation. Lock the geometry using the touchscreen and open the oven. Use the trimming tool to trim the excess amount of sample from the edge of the 25mm plate. Close the oven immediately. Set the gap to the final measurement gap. Now you are ready to perform the melt rheology experiments. Make sure that your method includes a soak time of at least 2 minutes so that the sample is equilibrated and relaxed prior to the start of the test. Typical melt rheology test procedures include an amplitude sweep to determine the linear viscoelastic region, a time sweep to evaluate the thermal process stability and the material stability at the test temperature, and a frequency sweep for viscoelastic characterization such as crossover frequency and crossover modulus, which can be subsequently used to calculate molecular weight and molecular weight distribution. In this tech tip, we have demonstrated how to load polymer pellets on the Discovery Hybrid Rheometer for running melt rheology experiments. Please stay tuned for more interesting TA Tech Tips, and thank you for your interest.